This is Jay Unger.
And Molly Mason, here at the Ashokan Center, alongside the Esopus Creek, where Barry Keegan is building a Lenape-style wigwam.
I'm here with Barry Keegan, who is starting the construction of Ashokan's wigwam. What do we have there? That is a tall pole.
It's a northern white cedar out of a swamp up near Cobleskill.
Oh, man.
I noticed a few of the same kind of tree on my way just as I came into the Ashokan property, or the park, I should say.
Yeah.
On that 28A. But I won't touch those. I'm sure somebody won't want me to do that.
So that's going to be...
I bring everything with me.
That's going to be bent over and be one of the main frameworks.
Yes.
Okay. Well, we can't wait to see the rest of it as it gets started. Barry, right over here, these are going to be most of the poles.
Yes. All the ones that go in the ground. We want cedar to last, so.
Right.
The horizontal ones do okay because they're not in the ground. So we can right. use maples and sometimes elms. Beech is not the best choice, but whatever I can get usually.
And what's the covering going to be?
Tulip tree bark,
mm-hmm.
mostly. And there may be some other strays in there.
Yeah.
If I can get elm, it's great, but I can't get that at a lumber yard because there's no market for the wood.
Right. Right. Well, there's a great tulip tree right there, but we're not going to bother it. It's going to just be just fine and healthy.
That's right. It's a solitary. We can't take the last one.
Right.
We return days later after Barry has all the inner frame poles firmly in the ground and is bending them into shape. We'll watch him twist them together and tie them in place with the inner bark of the basswood tree.
You made a lot of progress.
Once it gets rolling, and the biggest ones are done.
Though Barry has gathered all the materials off-site and brought them to Ashokan, they all occur in nature and are available within a couple of hundred feet of the new structure. All the work is done by hand, with no modern fasteners or tools, except for the ladder. Barry is adding an extra cedar pole to strengthen each of the two central hoops that will frame the doorway and smoke hole.
Flexible, so they get
gotta add some extra thickness to the roof here. I see. They're green.
As you can see, it takes a lot of force to twist the flexible green saplings around each other. Jay offers a hand.
Would an extra hand on that be helpful?
But Barry manages on his own, using a stick for leverage.
Uh-huh. Leverage. Wow.
See that?
Leverage does it. Amazing. I see the material you're tying it with. Is that inner bark?
Yes.
From the basswood?
You betcha.
Barry continues bending and twisting cedar poles to form the next hoop, and then ties them together using the strong inner bark of a basswood tree. Thank you. The outer covering of our wigwam is bark from a tulip tree. Barry gathers bark by visiting local sawmills and peeling logs before they're sawn. He then stacks and stores it in a dry place until needed for the next wigwam.
We're so grateful to Barry Keegan for bringing his skill and knowledge to Ashokan and building this inspiring and beautiful structure.